Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, and here we are again playing Titan Quest, the best game ever made. And this is the Discovolos build, which is a Slayer class, and I'm legendary difficulty, and I have finally arrived to the Palace of Hades. For the first time, as we can see from the Fog of War. And I will go through the palace now, and we will see how this build can perform in this area. This build has died 15 times so far in legendary. You know, all. Let's check out how many acts. One act of Atlantis, Orient, Egypt, Greece. And also Hades. So, five complete acts, almost complete, and 15 deaths in legendary. There is only Ragnarok act left to go through. And I think that this is a very good number of deaths. It is not many deaths because. As we can see, the elemental resistances suck totally. So yeah, in this department we have a very big problem. And this is why I consider 15 deaths to be okay. Now let's go kill something and see what happens. Of course, we can see how awesome it is to throw discs on enemies and kill them. I know, of course, that not everybody would like this type of weapon. And it makes sense, it is not strange. We cannot like the same things, all of us. But when it comes to my opinion, I think this is one of the best thrown weapon types of weapons. It is like throwing UFOs to your enemies, flying saucer. The very good thing about this build is that it is a fast build, and I have reached very fast this area. This stage of the game is legendary anyway. And it is fast because it kills enemies super very fast, especially in the previous acts, where enemies have less health and smaller levels. But it is still pretty fast at killing enemies in Hades Act. And of course it runs fast, maxed out movement speed all the time. So it is a very fast build to take through the whole campaign in legendary. And not only legendary, but you know. Nice. There is nothing here. I'm hoping for a couple of good drops. I'm not expecting any miracles when it comes to drops, but I would like to fight some drops. Okay, this is one of the areas of this palace where we can meet a dactyl. Let's see, can we deal with dactyls? There is no dactyl here. Okay. I guess I was lucky, but I'm very curious to see if this build has any problems against the dactyls and how easy or how hard it would be for this one to kill dactyls. Questions, questions, questions. I have only 18 energy potions, and this build eats potions like a bitch. I need to go buy potions. Especially energy potions. What did he say? Malaka. Of course, the skill that eats away too much energy is the slam skill, this one. 170 energy cost. And I don't have access to my full 510 energy because we have energy reserved, 135. So, yeah. We have to go and buy potions. Let's say dactyls here, no dactyls here. Okay, interesting. Things are very easy for now. It is only Dactyls and Hades himself I am concerned about, but not even Hades, I think. I just don't know what will happen if I face any Dactyls. This is my big problem. And the big question. Okay, so far so good. And here we have these two guys. These guys are very easy. Nice. Let's see, this is one more area that Dactyls may spawn at, so let's zoom out a little bit. Let's be careful. And here we have no Dactyls, okay. Nice. Okay, maybe here against this enemy I should call these guys. Yeah, let's do it. Because this enemy is very annoying. Well, I guess it was useless to call these guys. It didn't really help. But anyway, let's go. Now I hope I will have these guys with me available again as the skill after it the cooldown wears off. I want them to help me in my battle against Hades. Even though I don't really think I will need any help from these guys, the ancestral ghost warriors. They try to stun me, they stun me, but my stun resistance is not perfect, 57%. So, this stun resistance and this lightning resistance are going to be a big problem. A problem if I meet Dactyls, I mean, against the Dactyls. Because Dactyls deal stun, they deal physical damage and lightning damage. I don't think I have any problems when it comes down to physical damage mitigation. My armor is very good. Okay, the arm is not the best, but it is okay. Okay, I have to destroy this one, yes, nice. Very, very nice. I don't see any drops, any green items. But anyway, it is not like I'm trying to farm items now, I'm just going through the campaign. Nine energy potions, yeah. Very soon I will have to go back and buy some. Here we will fight against the second general. Come on, Prova Generale. Okay, now it is you and me. You and I. Suck! Bye bye. Let's go this way. I wanted to take down the archers first, especially those that also deal poison damage, or maybe sometimes fire damage as well. Now let's go in this area for the third general. Okay, this will be tough. Yeah, General Macaria is dead. Yeah, instead of them stunning me, I stunned them and then I killed them. No problemo. 5 energy potions. Okay, after my ghost warriors... they went away. I was going to say after they go away, I will go back to town. Let's go to Elysium and buy energy potions. And also health potions, yeah. Unfortunately, this build doesn't really have any attack damage converted to health, and it cannot heal back by attacking enemies. Heroism does not end with life. Look at the fields before you. Let's sell some use of the site. This is very nice. Transcendent of immortality. Weightless of the glade. Okay, anyway, let's forget about those ones. Let's go! Courage, hero! Courage! Okay, maybe this one will be a problem. No, not really. Honestly, I got to meet at least one dactyl. Let's see what will happen. I guess I will die most probably, but you never know. Maybe if I'm fast enough to stun the dactyl. You know, I have at least two stunning skills. This one is the first one, the other one is slam. Slam skill can stun enemies. So, if I can stun dactyl, the dactyl, it casts down also my battle standard. Then I think I will have small problems. Very, very small problems. Although this enemy here is a problem on its own. Whoa! This is why it is a problem. Okay, first I will take care of these ones. It drains your energy and it also deals damage to you, and this is very dangerous. Let's go! Open the door now that we have the battle standard on the ground. I see no dactyls. Unfortunately. Any dactyls? Yes, dactyl! A dactyl is here. Okay. First, I will go like this and see what happens. Whoa! Oh, yeah! This is what happens. I knew it. This happened because my lightning resistance is 0%. So. I know how I will deal with the dactyl. I will summon my ancestral horned warriors. They will go at the distract dactyl probably. I will also put down the battle standard. And hopefully he will not attack me with that attack, and I will hit him from a distance with my disc. And hopefully I will survive. Oops, that was a mistake. No! No, no! Whoa! Wow. Okay, this didn't work. So, he slows me down as well. My slowdown resistance is zero. Then we are going to be having a very huge problem with dactyls. Okay, so what do we do now? Do we use only slam and from a distance? Maybe I should summon something. Or maybe I should just use a scroll of avoidance. Or just summon the behemoth and get it over with. Nah, I don't really need to summon the behemoth. Opa! Okay. Yeah! Okay then, it was all about using slam from a distance along with Study Prey to reduce its physical resistances. So yeah, dactyls are the true boss in this area for this build. This build has a very big problem against the dactyls. Okay, let's create... Where is it? 3 and 2. Tusu! Why am I so unlucky? I got it the bonus to be resistances. Now, let's go fight Hades. Let's see what we can do against Hades. You Okay, I guess Hades is very easy. Yeah, I told you, the true boss for this build in this palace is not Hades, it is Dactyl. Okay, super duper easy. Star of Elysium, very nice drop. But the other drops are useless. I have defeated. So, what do we get out of this run? Well, Dactyls are the true boss for this build. And this place is super easy for this build, except for Dactyls, nothing else. And here we are in Ragnarok. This is the final act I have to go through with this build. And after I go through this act and I finish the journey, I will make an update video, build guide update video for this build. And I will upload the video, of course. So, guys, this is it for this video. It was a playthrough through the Palace of Hades of this Kovalos version 2 build, which is very powerful, very amazing. Of course, it has some weaknesses, but when you go with so much power, you want to stack so much physical power and whatnot, you will have some weaknesses. You cannot have everything. So, thanks for watching this video. Remember to subscribe. We have, you cannot even imagine how much content of Titan Quest we have coming up. And I will see you very soon, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hitting the like button. Thanks for sharing the video. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for being here. And I'll be back very soon. Have fun, whatever you do.